I had come to terms with, if I did lose my baby right here, regardless of what happened, I needed to turn my life back around. I was diagnosed with polycystic ovarian syndrome. You'll have cysts on your ovaries, you won't be able to conceive, and if you do, you won't make it past the first trimester. I went through a period where it was kind of like a breaking point where I felt like I couldn't take life anymore. I had an issue with self-harm. I hated myself, and eventually my mom told me, we're not doing this anymore. You need help. I did therapy and I got put on medication. My psychiatrist found out I was not on birth control, and he told me that the side effects of the mood stabilizer I was on is very dangerous for babies in the womb, that it would cause severe birth defects. And they tell me I can't get pregnant, it doesn't matter, but he told my mom that if I didn't get some type of birth control or Mirena or something, that he was not going to prescribe me any more medication. I met with my doctor, we discussed it. She asked me, like, why do you need this? And so I told her, and a nurse handed me a Dixie cup and told me that she wanted a urine sample. So I gave her the urine sample and the Dixie cup, and I went back to my room. Moments later, my nurse came in and told me, when the doctor comes in, you need to tell her we have to wait because I believe you're pregnant. I was already considered high-risk pregnancy because of the polycystic ovarian syndrome. And so then with this mood stabilizer, it made me, like, really high-risk. They did their exam and they would gently be like, and you know, in this situation, abortion is best recommended. This baby doesn't have a chance. You're going to bring into the world a child who will not live. You're gonna bring in a child who's gonna have special needs that you're gonna have to pay for. You're a single mom, you're gonna have to do it on your own. My child was referred to as tissue, not even fetus, tissue. When I was 21 weeks pregnant, I was experiencing pressure. Called up to the nurse hotline and told them what I was experiencing, and they told me because I was high risk, I needed to go to the hospital right away. And they told me I was having contractions almost every 4 minutes. And so we had asked, can't you give me medicine to stop the contractions? Isn't there anything else you can do? And she said, it wasn't protocol because it's not a baby until 24 weeks. All we can do is help deliver the tissue. And really, she was prepping me for a partial birth abortion. A nurse said that she heard the situation of what was going on, and she recommended they send us to the Avera McKinnon Hospital in Sioux Falls because they have a ward for high-risk pregnancies. And the doctor told her it wasn't protocol, and they kind of argued a little bit back and forth, and eventually the nurse left. We fought it for as long as we could, and then she just said, we have to do this now. And right as they, you know, approached my bed, this other nurse came just running in, saying she called the Avera McKinnon Hospital. They agreed to accept me. She's already got an ambulance waiting downstairs for me, and she just unhooked me from the IV bag hanging up, and before anybody could say anything, was already wheeling me down the hallway. And so I got in the ambulance, and I went to Sioux Falls, and I ended up carrying her till 39 weeks, which is full term. I didn't realize it would be such a big thing for somebody to be potty trained, you know, whenever it first steps, even just drinking out of a regular cup. Like, that brings so much joy to my life, and I want to be a better person for her because I want to encourage her to stay away from the things I never stayed away from, for her to achieve the things I never achieved. Everything I do for her to be a better mother for her is in some way glorifying God, and part of serving God is raising godly children. It's probably the happiest thing of my life, seeing her and being able to experience. And I find myself sitting back, looking at her, thinking, wow, that's my kid.